way back to the ballroom with, they might be giants.
All right, thanks a lot, Jeff. Yes, I'm here with the founding members of They Might Be Giants, John Flansburgh, John Linnell.
Hey, Karen.
Hi.
Hey.
So thanks for coming.
People don't know that Karen actually played our records back when nobody played our records.
I did, back in my radio
in the early 70s.
Well, I was telling somebody I premiered Anna Ang that time, and I played at the wrong speed.
Yeah? Yeah. Well, who knew?
Right? We had heard it before.
No,
there was no speed on the record.
No.
Right. So 12-inch single. I was
confused. 12-inch singles. That was... Right.
So actually, now this is a great transition. You guys are so good at this. You guys just told me you recently recorded something new, hot off the presses for a movie.
That's right. Yeah,
we've done
what's
three
about?
Actually.
Well, we've done a bunch of things recently, but one of them was the was for the soundtrack of the Mighty Morphin Power Rangers.
Really?
Ka-ching.
Nice. I don't have to get involved in that.
That movie. We're friends with the orange one, the one that, has the special power of reading bands and
side project agent sort of manager thing. Yeah.
Right.
Cool.
And we also just did this XTC tribute record.
Uh-huh.
I mean, a song for they're having a tribute record.
Which song did you choose?
We tried to do This Is Pop, which actually proved to be too difficult for us, and we did this, instead we did this Dukes of Stratosphere psychedelic song called 25 O'Clock.
Yeah, well, I mean, XTC was such a, that's why they don't tour, John, the things are too hard to do.
That's exactly right.
Right?
I mean, that's why
we shouldn't tour.
No, but you are touring and you're going to Europe, right?
Yes.
We went to Europe already.
Oh, you went to Europe.
We're going to another example.
Forget about Europe.
Where are you going?
Europe's over. We're going to the Far East.
Really?
We're going to exotic.
Japan, really?
Hong Kong, and we're playing in Australia and
New Zealand.
Yeah, are you going to Singapore? Be careful.
No.
What? Hey, you know, we're going to Tokyo. They got, you know, nerve gas there.
So. Cool.
Who cares about gas?
Can you get me some of the duty-free shop on the way out?
The nerve gas.
Nerve gas. They got plenty. They just confiscated a whole lot.
Did they? Yeah, right, great. I know, that's
They're
bad.
They're putting on planes back to the U.S.
Yeah. So listen, guys, you guys, John Henry, you guys obviously formed a band.
Yeah, can we introduce our band here for you?
Absolutely, if you'd like to.
Tony Mamoni on the bass, ladies and gentlemen, from Bob Mould and Perubu.
Yeah.
We got Brian Doherty on the drums.
Yeah.
We got Timothy Newman on the trombone.
All right.
And we got Mr. Jim O'Connor. On the trumpet, ladies and gentlemen.
So now, what's the best thing about having these guys on board as part of They Might Be
All Giants? The swearing.
Really?
Yeah. All the swearing that goes on, it's like being in the army.
Oh, yeah? Do you learn anything new? I know you can't really share it with us.
Horrible, sick things that only guys can share with each other in a van.
Really?
And hearing disorders from live volume.
Yeah.
Do you guys still travel in the van?
We actually travel in a car, which is even, seems... on rock and roll in a way, but actually it's we don't really like being on the bus. I mean, nobody, you know, likes to come on the bus.
All right.
You'd rather drive all day. Sleeping on a bus is like sleeping on a park bench, so it's really uncomfortable.
Yeah, and they're very cramped.
In your own coffin.
Right.
Yeah.
Well, it's going to be kind of like what you're going to be sleeping in Japan, probably. It's not a big, spacious place.
Yeah, no, we've done that before.
All right, well, listen, this is the deal. It's time for you guys to play. So,
okay.
What are we going to hear?
This is a song called Spy. It's off our new record, John Henry.
Well, okay. The camera's going to go on you now, because we're going to get up.
Yeah.
Okay. All right, so this is
Karen Bryant, here.
Thank you.
Karen.
This is filler time now, when They Might Be Giants start to take their places over at the band.
I think we're in position here.
Ladies and gentlemen, yes, this should be fun. We'll be right back. That's great. Now, do you guys still have the dial-a-song going?
Oh, yeah, we got dial-a-song.
Yeah?
200 calls a day. It's all computerized.
Really?
Right next to my kitchen.
What's
sink.
The number?
718-387-6962.
Oh, yeah? And I love that you wrote it's free if you call from work.
That's absolutely right. It's still totally free. Regular call to Brooklyn. Your parents need not know.
Excellent.
Right?
Excellent.
And you're at work.
Yes, I am at work.
Yeah.
I'm dialing away. So, excellent. Thank you, guys. I know you're going to hang for a bit, right?
All right. Well,
so cool. We're
going to
keep playing. Jeff, are we... Yeah,
yeah, keep
go
on
ahead.
Playing.
Go, guys,
still to come on Sound Effects. More from They Might Be Giants. Crank it up, guys, anytime.
Hey,
we want to keep...
We also have 60 Seconds of Fame up next. Nope, I recorded. We'll be right back.
I'm sitting here with John Flansburg of They Might Be Giants, and John, this is the part in the program where, unlike you, who's now a big, huge, successful rock star, we like to introduce people on the air who've not been signed yet and who don't have, you know, record deals and stuff.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, so we call it 60 Seconds of Fame, and what people have been doing is sending in videos of their bands, and tonight we've got a group called Uncle. They're from here in New York.
Oh, all right.
Yeah, and so the song's called Lemon Lip Gloss. They've got 60 seconds to impress us, so yeah, let's check it out.
He's wearing a blonde wig.
He is. 60 Seconds of Fame.
I detect a wig. That's good. Glasses, strong.
All right, folks, that was Uncle Lemon Lip Gloss. That was our 60 Seconds of Fame tonight. Did you think you liked it?
Easy to dance to. I'd give it a 98.
Excellent, John. So this is the deal. They're going to put out their first independent CD this summer, too.
Cool.
So you can take that 60
I'm
Seconds
I'm looking
at the
teleprompter. And
no prompter, baby.
Wow.
No net. All right, it's time to find out. John Linnell is going to introduce us over there to what in the world a zither is. John?
Hello. I'm here with Mr. Brian Pierre Duan. Songwriter, carpenter, musician, and what have you got here, Brian?
Well, let me tell you, John, this is an electric zither.
It's got 88 strings. I can play melodies up here. I can play chords. And bass.
Why, that's fantastic!
And Brian, tell me, who built this zither?
Well, I built it myself, John, in my basement.
It's amazing.
In the year 1989.
And
it's still here today.
Do you want to describe the way you've got your rig set up here? You've got some other...
Well, I've got
here.
These 8 humbucker pickups here to power it with, and it goes to my Leslie rotating speaker, so I can change the speed the motors turn around. And get a mechanical tremolo sound. And I have these pedals to step on to change the sound like this.
Excellent. That's wonderful. So you actually have some releases here we can hold up for the camera.
That's
right. This is Brian DeWan's Hello CD of the Month Club selection. Actually, he's got a couple here. One of them features the electric zither. And then this is your Bar None release.
That's right, my full-length record album.
It's called Brian DeWan Tells a Story, and you're going to do a song from this record, right?
That's right. It's called Obedience School, and
right.
It goes like this. Back when I was in obedience school, I could make a rabbit stew. I could fix a sewage pipe. I could build a beaver dam. Then I moved to a rooming house. No one tells me what to do. Now I play with bottle caps. I can break a drinking glass. People tell me every day, don't tell people what to do. Well, that's all right, I'll do it like you tell me to. Everybody is in charge. Cooks are plenty, making broth for everyone, bumping into everyone. But back when I was in obedience school,
I could fold a paper plane. I could wear a pilgrim hat. I could ring the dinner bell, sit beside a metronome, listen to an intercom, file into a corridor, be made to do a jumping jack, spend the afternoon indoors, making useful things from trash, learn to fill a candy dish, eat a can of tuna fish, scour and scrub a basement sink, sweep around a skating rink. Oh, those bygone days, they were so peaceful and gray.
Nice job.
Thank you, Brian.
Brian DeWine. Guys, thanks very much. We'll wrap up the big show and Sound Effects Returns right after this. You want to play us out? Sound Effects, before we get to more from They Might Be Giants, we want to thank everybody. David Petras, as always, for enlightening us. Joe Levy for starting a good, another argument. Led us right into another segment. You and I are going to arm wrestle one night.
Well, plus I like the Pavement record, so we need to talk about that.
And David Gross helping out, Matt.
Yeah, thank you, man. I got a new career.
Excellent.
All right.
But yes, we do have to thank They Might Be Giants. I know you guys are going out of the country, but you said you're going to play on the West Coast some dates?
Yeah.
Excellent. The album is called John Henry. You should pick it up as you should pick up all the other ones. And thanks again, you guys.
See you tomorrow for more Sound Effects, everybody.
Ben Lee tomorrow night, folks.
Hush, my darling.